Hey guys, Virtualix here, back here with another video, and today I'm going to show you guys how to install Android L, the new developer preview, on your Nexus 7 2013 or your Nexus 5. So without any further ado, let's jump right into the video. Now I'm going to perform this installation on a Nexus 7, but you can also do the same for your Nexus 5, and it doesn't matter whether you're rooted or not. And also make sure to take a backup, because this will erase everything on your device. Now once you're done with the backup and everything, the first thing you need to do is go to this website right here. I'll leave the link to it down below in the description. And what you need to do is download the ADT for Mac and the new developer image for your device. If you're using a Nexus 5, it's going to be the Hammerhead, and if you're using a Nexus 7 2013, it's going to be the Razer. Now after both of the files have been downloaded, go ahead and extract them both. And I've already extracted the ADT bundle, but I'm going to extract the Razer image right now. Now once that's done, go ahead and open up the ADT folder and then go to SDK. And then go ahead and select the Platform Tools folder. And now what you need to do is open up the Android L image folder. And what you need to do right now is very important. Go ahead and select all the files in the image folder and drag and drop them to the Platform Tools folder. And upon dropping the files, if you get this message, go ahead and select Apply to All and then hit Replace. Now once the files have been copied, you can go ahead and close out the image folder. And then what you need to do right now is open up Terminal. Now in the terminal window, what you need to do is go ahead and type in cd and drag and drop the whole Platform Tools folder onto your terminal window and then press enter. After that, what you need to do is go ahead and connect your device to your computer. And once that's done, go ahead and unlock your device. And then go into settings. And then scroll down till you find about tablet. And then go ahead and tap on build number a couple of times until it says you're a developer. And then go back and then go into developer options and then scroll down till you find USB debugging and then hit OK and always allow from this computer and then hit OK. Now once USB debugging has been turned on, go back to your computer and into the terminal window type in /adb /devices and then press enter. Now if you performed all the previous tasks correctly, it's going to show your device connected. And we're going to be rebooting into the bootloader mode now, so we're going to be typing in /adb /reboot/bootloader and then press enter. And we are now successfully into the bootloader of our device. Now if you look closely in the bottom portion of the screen, it says that the lock state is locked, and we're going to be unlocking it right now to install Android L. Now if your device shows the lock state as unlocked, you can go ahead and skip this step, but if it doesn't, go ahead and type in /fastboot /OEM and then /unlock and then press enter. Now when this message shows up on your device, press the volume up button to go to yes and then press the power button to confirm and unlock the bootloader. And that now your device has been rebooted and the lock state is now showing as unlocked, you're one step closer to installing Android L. Now on your computer, into the Platform Tools folder, open up the file named as flashall.sh. And now what you need to do is basically type in /" in front of the last three lines. And once that's done, go ahead and save the file and exit the document. And now what we're going to do is in the terminal window type in /flash-all.sh and press enter. Now it's going to take about 10 minutes to install the whole operating system, so I'm going to fast forward it as fast as I can to save time, and I'll be back as soon as the installation completes. And well, there we go. So we are now successfully at the setup screen of Android L. So I'm going to go ahead and set the device up. And so we got a warning message that says that this is not a stable version of the developer preview. I know that. And I'm gonna sign into my Wi-Fi now. And so it's checking the connection. And then checking for software update. And then we have some tap and go features. So that's new. And skip this. Just a second. No, I'm not gonna add my account right now. Skip anyway. And I'm also gonna skip this. Next. And more, and next, and then finish. So there you go guys, we are now successfully running Android L on our devices. Now please make sure that this is still a developer preview and not stable. And yeah, so that's pretty much it guys. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, make sure to hit that like button down below, and also make sure to subscribe to the channel if you want to see more content like this, more Android L content, unboxings, reviews, and much more. I'll catch you all later in the next video. Peace. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching that video. If you enjoyed, make sure to hit that like button down below. Also, if you are sticking around for a moment, make sure to check out my unboxing and first look at the Knievel ZX100 mini speaker. And also make sure to follow me on Twitter and Instagram. All those links will be in the description down below, as well as on the screen right now with an annotation.